Next, the concept is PACS architecture. PACS, it is also called as PCS. PACS is nothing but Personal Access Communication System. It is a third generation personal communication system, which is called as PCS, which is able to support voice, data, and video images for indoor and micro cell use. Next, PCS, it is a personal communication system. Personal communication service, it is a wireless phone service, which is similar to the cellular telephone. It is also referred to as digital cellular. The technologies that are used for PCS are time division multiple access, code division multiple access, global system for mobile communication, that is GSM. So the main goal of PCS is to provide mobile user with voice, data, multimedia at any place, at any time, and in any format, and video images for indoor and micro cell use. So it is designed to provide coverage within 500 meter range. Because it's a wireless communication system, it is designed to provide coverage within 500 meters range. So the main objective of PCS is to integrate all forms of wireless local loop communication into one system with full telephone features in order to provide wireless connectivity for local exchange carriers, which is called as LEC. So the whatever the wireless local loop communications are there, those are integrated together with full duplex telephone features to provide wireless connectivity for LEC. It is also called as WACS, that is Wireless Access Communication System. It uses 10 time slots, TDMA or FDMA, in 2 milliseconds frame and 500 kbps data rate. Next, coming to the architecture of PACS or PCS, the PACS was developed as Universal Wireless Access System for widespread applications in private and public telephone systems, which will operate either in licensed or unlicensed PCS bands. So the architecture mainly consisting of PCS technologies that have grown rapidly in telecommunications industry. The two of the most popular are cellular telephony, cordless, and low tier PCS technology. The basic architecture, it consists of two parts: radio network, wireless transport network. And it has the main components: subscriber unit, radio port control unit, and access manager. So what is a radio network? So PCS, it uses many mobile stations to communicate with base stations in personal communication system network. The mobile station, it is either handset or mobile phone, subscriber unit, or portable, whichever it is preferable for you. Here the term subscriber unit is used when we describe wireless local loop, WLL. For that one, you'll be using the subscriber unit. And portable means if we have a low tier system such as personal access communication system, you'll be using the term portable. And the mobile station, we can describe it is as GSM system, global system for mobile communication system. And this is the basic PACS network architecture, which is consisting of PSTN, MSC, radio network, base station, BSC, mobile station, and wireline transport network. Here, the subscriber unit, it can be fixed or portable. RP, it can fixed or portable. The subscriber unit can be fixed or portable. And radio port, it is connected to RPCU and access manager. The interface A, it is nothing but it provides a connection between subscriber unit and radio port. Next, integrated P, it provides the protocol required to connect subscriber unit through RP to RPCU, and also it connects RPCU with its RP using embedded operations channel, that is EOC. Okay, these are the components which are used in PACS architecture. And PSTN means it's public switched telephone network, the mobility database, mobile switching center. So whatever the mobile switching center consists means it consists of billing activities and the connections to make the call. All the calling processing activities and the billing activities all should be passed through MSC. It is the heart of the cellular network, which is also called as mobile telephone switching office. Next, base station. The base station, it provides the strongest signal. It is also referred to as tower in general. And the mobile station, it is a mobile phone. Next, it's a wireline transport network and the radio network. Next, how the radio network has been used here means the coverage of the base station or whatever the sector in the base station, it is called as cell. For the system such as GSM and PSES, the base stations, it is partitioned into controller and radio transmitters or receivers. So controller means here, you can consider BSC in GSM and radio port control unit in PSES. Likewise, how the BSC is used in GSM system, similar way, radio port control unit is used in PSES systems. Next, radio transmitters or receivers. So base transceiver stations, BST, BTS in GSM and radio ports in PSES. BSC in GSM and RPCU in PSES. Likewise, BTS in GSM and radio ports in PSES. The similar operation can be carried out as in GSM. Next, the base stations, it usually reach wireline transport network via land links or dedicated microwave links. Because the telephone links, whatever the information, it is of high speed and data, normal coaxial cables cannot able to transmit that information. So you'll be using dedicated microwave links or LAN links in order to transmit this particular high speed data. Normal coaxial cables cannot carry such high speeds. This is a CDMA based transceiver stations. You can see the figure. Next, it is a base station controller, that is CDMA BSE, BSC. And the wireline transport network, MSC, it is connected to base station in a special switch that is using mobile switching center, which acts like a switch to switch from analog to digital or digital to analog. This MSC is used. It is connected to PSTN to provide services between the PCS users and wireline users. And MSC, it also communicates with the databases to track the locations of mobile stations. Next, this is a figure regarding MSC, mobile switching center. Next, coming to the PSES radio interface. What are the interfaces used in the PSES means? The forward link, it consisting of frequency 1850 megahertz to 1910 megahertz. And the reverse link, it is 1930 megahertz to 1900 megahertz. So the time slots that are used in 2 milliseconds frame, and if a large number of radio channels used are FDM and TDM with 80 megahertz separation, the channel bandwidth, it is 300 kilohertz for PSES. And the type of modulation used is pi by 4 DQPSK, that is differential quadrature phase shift keying. And the speech coding here, it uses 32 kbps adaptive delta pulse code modulation for digital speech encoding. And the channels used for PSES are synchronous channel, slow channel, fast channel. So this is about the PSES architecture, features, radio interface, and the similar characteristics used in GSM, BTS, BSC, radio ports, radio fixed ports, control unit, radio port control unit. This is about PSES.